Hi, a very good morning. This is Abhay from Manupatra Information Solutions. Thank you for joining me for an orientation session on Manupatra. I hope you are at home, safe with your family at this difficult time for all of us. Let's make the most of it by brushing up on our legal research skills. This is part one of the three sessions that we are organizing for law students. This session will be approximately 40 minutes. So any questions that you might have, we can discuss it in a 10-15 minutes Q&A after the end of the session. Let me begin with a brief introduction to Manupatra Information Solutions. We started our journey in 2000 as the pioneers of online legal search in India. Today, we have grown into the largest content aggregator for Indian and international database with our offices in 22 cities across India. We're living in a digital age, so we are creating tons and tons of data every day. So the focus of the company is to give our users an ability to focus on the relevant judgments using technologies like artificial intelligence, visualization tools, editorial enhancements at right places, so that you can get to the relevant judgment at the quickest time. Let me begin with the demo. So we are assuming that you have somewhat legal knowledge, but no information about Manupatra. So we'll be starting everything from the scratch. So whenever you'll write manupatra.com here, so either it will load to manupatra.com or manupatrapass.com. Okay. So this will be either you can log into the system by username password. So you'll fill this username password. If your college has an IP subscription from Manupatra, so there's another option available. IP users click here. So that will be available whenever you will be connected to the to your college's IP address or Wi-Fi, that option will be available here. Sign in. Now this will be my home screen. Okay. So on the left hand side, this is the table of contents. On the right hand side, we have Manu search, legal search, citation search, assisted search. These are the different searches to search this table of content. Today we'll be primarily focusing on the table of content and we'll take one judgment. And I'll show you how a judgment looks on Manupatra. Okay. So table of content, there are two major uses of a table of content. First, it will show you where a particular document is located in Manupatra server. So if you're looking for a say notification, this is where the notification circle is there. The second one being if you're making a search. So if you're looking for a Supreme Court judgment, so that you can filter from here. So you can just click it here. Now you can go to Manu search and make your search. Then it will only search in the particular Supreme Court judgments. Okay. Let's start with the content. So this is for Supreme Court. So for Supreme Court, we cover judgments from 1950 to today. So from inception till today, all the judgments are available on the website. Coming to the Supreme Court orders from 1980 onwards till today, all the Supreme Court orders are also there. Coming to the high courts and tribunal and other courts, so all the 24 high court judgments are available on the website. So from inception, you will be able to find all the judgments from various high courts. Let's show you one, say Calcutta High Court. So for Calcutta, it is the oldest court in India. So from 1860 till today, all the judgments are available from Calcutta High Court. Similarly, we have other courts also. Say Privy Council, Federal Courts, Lahore Courts. So these are the pre-independence courts. So dating back from 1850 till today, all the judgments are also available from these courts. So very comprehensive coverage. Coming to the tribunals and commissions. So tribunals and commissions, we cover all the major tribunals and commissions, 40 of them. So CAT, NCLT, CIC, VRT, all these tribunals are available. Say, let's go to NCLT. NCLT is very popular these days among advocates. So all the different benches are also here. So if you want to see from a New Delhi bench judgment, that we also you can see from here. We update orders from all the tribunals fairly frequently. Say international database, we cover Commonwealth English speaking countries plus US and UK. International Court of Justice is also there. Say for United States, it covered Supreme Court judgments from inception. Say it started from 1760. So till today, all the judgments you will be able to see from United States. This is the benefit of using Manupatra, or one where everything is available in one go. So the, both the national database and international database is available. So if you are searching for a query like right to privacy, so this is as much as a global thing as much as an Indian thing. So you can search both the database simultaneously in Manupatra. Now coming to the next one, this is business policy. So what we have done in business policy is very interesting. So for a particular subject of law, both the primary and secondary database is available in one folder. Say I am a corporate lawyer. So what I mean by primary database is all the central acts, state acts, rules. So these are directly coming from the authority. So this is the primary database. Now there are secondary database, which includes committee reports, annual reports. So these are also available. So anything that is in the public domain related to corporate law is provided to you under one folder. So whenever I need to keep myself updated on a particular, on my topic, so I can go to this folder and I can see what else is available, what is the new notification that has been coming, which are the due dates and penalties. So due diligence part is also there. So many a times what happens in Manupatra is that people think there are only judgments, but we cover a lot of other things. Their press releases also. So very comprehensive. At one place you'll be able to access everything. Similarly, we have capital law, real estate. So all this also is available on the real estate front. So if you want to see on the real estate subject, so the same are available. This is a frequently asked question. So there are many editorial announcements also. So these are prepared by sometimes by our legal team. So these are the commonly asked questions related to FAQ. So you can just read them if you have a problem related to a particular subject. This is available for arbitration also. Let's go to the next one, which is corporate law and taxation. So GST is an evolving subject of law. So new press releases keep on coming. There's different forms. So as a tax lawyer, to keep myself updated for any new notification that is coming from the government is very, very important. So everything is available to me here under one folder. Now coming to the notification and circulars, you might be aware that various ministries keep coming out with their different notifications. So we cover central as well as state. So state, we are the only one that are covering the state notification circulars. Let me show you one, say notification circulars from 2020 to 2020 onwards. These are various ministries. We can open any one, say Ministry of Health and Family Affairs. Go to table of contents, 2020. These are the all available. I'll open any one. Okay, so this is there. This is one notification, how a notification looks on Manupatra. Now I'd like to bring your attention to this thing, which is hyperlinking. So everything is hyperlinked. So if you go to a government website, find the same notification, you'll have to find, or you have to go to 10 different websites to find the references. Okay, so everything is available here. Different notifications. So click on to that one. That will take you to the separate notification. Now section wise also hyperlinking is there. So if section 11 is mentioned, you can read what is section 11. Okay, so everything is there and it is being comprehensively hyperlinked with each other. So this is the benefit of using one point system. Again, gadget copy is also available. So if you want to see as it is appearing on the government website, this is there. If you want a PDF copy of it, if you want to send it as a mail, that you can do. If you can save this document to view later, that is also available. This was for notification circulars. Let's come to the Bare Acts. Bare Acts, very important folder for any legal person. So central as well as state Bare Acts are available. For central FLC, I further categorized into state Bare Acts and rules and regulations. Once you click on the Bare Act, this is the table of contents. Okay, now this has been further classified chronological wise, year wise, alphabetical wise, subject wise, industry wise. So FMCG, I want to see that I can see. Now let me go back to the alphabetical one. Okay. So A, B, C, D, all the variables are available. When I click all, the entire list is available for all the central variables in one go. Okay. Now I can see this is the Aadhaar Act 2016 and this is the amendment. So we put amendment that is separately and this will be amended. This will be as per today as 2016. This will be there. Now let me show you one VAR Act comprehensively. Say Consumer Protection Act. Now I'll show you that this 1986 one has been repealed. Now 2019 is the new one. But there is this small flag that is appearing here. What does that mean? That means that the date of enforcement for this is yet to be notified. Okay. So this has not been notified yet. This is a very small but very relevant information for me. So this is there. This many small features like that available so that you are well aware when you are going to the court or when you are preparing for a particular moot that this is there. Now for any Bare Act, there are these options available from here. Okay, on the left hand side, these are the different features. Now I'll click each one of them. Say view in single document. So if you want to see this in a single document, that you can see. So this is there. Section wise, if you want to read the commentary on this, commentary is also available. If you want to simply copy paste, that you can do. If you want to take out a printout of this, that is also available. Any amendment that has come, any notification that has come, so that will be linked to this, inserted by section 62 2002. You can go to which amendment was there. So everything is available. You can read the entire act. If you want to read the commentary, so commentary is also available for any act. Section 5, I want to read the commentary. Okay, so this is there. Both the primary database, which is the Bare Act, and the secondary, if you want to read the commentary, that is available in one folder. Okay, let's go back to Consumer Protection Act. Similarly, notations, if you want to read annotations on that one, that is also there. This is again very helpful. This is a comparative chart. So for any Bare Act, 2019 is there, 1986. Now there, like which section has become what? So earlier section 2.5 was this one. Section 2.1b was complaint. Now it's 2x5. So just to refresh yourself, this is available. Comparison between the repealed act and the current act. Similarly, rules and regulations related to particular act is also there. If you want to read the rules simultaneously with the act, that is all available. If you want to see brief facts, so if there is any amendment pending on this, what is the subjective, what is the objective before, statement of objective is there. Now, if you want to see this particular act in vernacular, so in Hindi, Gujarati, Marathi, so different forms if you want to see, that is also available. So these are some of the functions. Now, this is also a hyperlink. If you click on this one, what happens is, you'll be able to see different sections, section wise, section 1, section 2. Now I want to read section 8. So I can click on section 8 and it will ask me whether I want to read the act or the commentary. I want to read the act. So here, section 8 is available. Judgment on section 8 is available. You can take out a printout from here also. So the printout option is available everywhere. Now, if you want to see judgments on section 8, this is very, very relevant. So if you want to see judgments on this, so this is the button, the blue button is there. I want to see judgments on section 8. You don't have to do much. This is on, these are the results on section 8 of Consumer Protection Act. Similarly, if you want to read the commentary, the option of commentary is always available. Okay. Now let me show you one more feature. Say, Companies Act 2019, this is another one. So if any amendment is pending on that particular act, that is also reflected here. So you can click onto this one and you will be able to see that there is a bill that is pending on this particular thing. That is also there. So what you should appreciate is how detailed it is. So everything is available to you from an authority source. It's coming and everything, you can't miss anything from this. So any query that you might have related to any bear act you want to see, so that is all available here in one folder. You can read the judgments here, you can read the commentary here, you can read the rules and regulations. Everything is available to you in one folder from here. Okay. Similarly, rules and regulations are also available. So rules and regulations for central as well as state. This is for central. Similarly, rules are available for states also. So this is for state barracks. Bills, drafts, and ordinances. So for bills, drafts, and ordinances, we have different folders. One is committee reports. So if you click on committee reports, it will give you different categorization is in terms of subject. So I want to read different government, non-government bodies keep coming up with their recommendations for the subject. So these are all available here. Similarly, constituent assembly debates, these are also very helpful. So if you want to go back to the how this law was formed, so that is also available, volume 1, volume 12. Similarly, court fees is also there, court rules, drafts and agreements. So you're doing an internship, you need to form a particular draft. So all that is also available. Both the Word and PDF formats are available for these drafts. Let's click on one, say trademark. This is how it looks. If you want to download the Word format, you can do. If you want to download the PDF format, that if you want to send it as a mail, that is also available. Coming to pending bills and ordinances. So pending bills, these are the bills that are pending in the parliament. So different for 17th Lok Sabha, 16th Lok Sabha, let's say chronological. 2019, 2020, let's go for 2020. So 2020, you will be able to see the title of the bill, bill number, objective and purpose, house status, assent date. So assent date is very important. Sometimes what happens that you know that there is a particular bill that's been passed, but the assent date is yet to come. That is also available here. Similarly, you have as it was introduced, as it was passed by Lok Sabha, as it was passed by both houses. So we're living in a world of WhatsApp universities. So it's always good idea to go to their basic source text and read from there. These bills are available for all the. Okay, coming to stamp duty. So stamp duty is also available. Suit valuations for different courts is also available. Let's come to forms. Statutory forms on different subjects are here. Miscellaneous. So in miscellaneous, what we have is budget session. So budget union and railway budget is there. This is uploaded the same day it comes out. Extradition treaties. So extradition treaties with different countries, UK, US, that you can see from here. Nation cases in news. So these are the district high court cases that are popular in news. So we have provided them here. So Salman Khan might be here somewhere. Okay, this is for miscellaneous. Coming to the e-books. So different subject matters, say Code of Civil Procedure, Criminal Procedure. This book is also there. You can click on anyone. You can download it if you want to read it later. That option is also available. Academic ebooks. So academic ebooks are like regular ebooks. This one thing is there. It is not there in the regular. It has hyperlinking. So hyperlinking allows you to go to, if there is any judgment that has been mentioned in this, you can directly go to that judgment. You can read that judgment from here. You can go back to the book. So this is possible only in a digital medium. Otherwise, you have to open 10 different books. Okay, so this is academic ebooks. Another one is articles. So we receive articles from professionals. We receive them from students. If you want to submit your own articles, you can do that. From here, you can select subject-wise. You can select the year of publication. Say you can select. You want to select something from this. That way also you can. Okay, coming to the next one, this is legal taxonomy. So legal taxonomy basically is an hierarchical structure. So this is just like a digest. So like your book, there is a subject, say civil procedure, and there is a sub-subject, say incident proceeding. So different sub-subject you have to select, and at the end of it you will get judgments on that one. So this is based on like your book only, so you don't have to even search in Manu search, or you don't even have to search in legal search. Everything is available. Just follow which subject you want to go to, which sub-subject you want to go to. So everything is available from here. This is legal taxonomy. Now coming to the other part, we have approximately 20-30 minutes available with us. So let's go to the search part also. So what I'll give you is a brief taste of some of our most used features. We can have a detailed session on this tomorrow. I will explain all the features. Today I'm just going to show you the main features, our most used features. This is also going to be much more interesting part of the demo. So we have, because this is our bread and butter, this is basically what we have built our brand upon. So there are different searches. There is Manu search, legal search, citation search, assisted search. So Manu search is a text-based search. So this is very popular among all the people we go to clients. They've been using it for 20 years. This is their favorite search. The best thing about it is that it uses artificial intelligence. It uses natural language processing. What that means in simple words is that you don't have to think much when you are searching in Manu search. As the query is coming into your head, you can just type it here. So you need not frame any query. You don't add plus minus many software use those kind of things. So you can just write your query here. Say compassionate appointment for divorced daughter. Okay. So in a matter of seconds, it has searched through millions of judgments and it has come out with 510 relevant results for me. Okay. So this happens in half a second. Okay. So these are all the judgments. These are the filters that we are for Supreme Court. So these filters are basically designed so that you can narrow your search. So if I just want judgments from 220, 210 and above, that I can do. If I want to read articles on this one, there are articles available. Similarly, if I have a particular industry in mind, that I can do. If I want to read judgments with a higher judgment first, that is also available. Now this is my first search result. Now I don't want to read it first. I don't want to read the judgment. I want to see the case note first. So how can I do that? This is the button. So this is Manu Instant. So what Manu Instant does for you is it gives you a brief editorially enhanced synopsis of the judgment. So this is the name of the decision date, subject wise, citing reference is like there were 9 cases that were discussed or cited in this case. So 2 of them were discussed, 7 were mentioned. Once you click on to this one, it will give you which are those 2 cases that were discussed in this case. Act, case note is there, appeal was dismissed. Now I can read what it was held. In every case of death of a government servant in harness, it may not be possible to appoint one of the dependents. There was no vested right to compassionate appointment, no merit to the claim in apparent. A divorced debtor for her compassionate appointment of death. So this is dismissed. So is not given her compassionate appointment. So now I'll read the second one. So this is the second one. So decision date. Subject, okay. Dependent, divorced daughter dependent upon father, continue to be the liability of the father, has to be included within the meaning of the word family. So here, she has been granted compassionate appointment. Okay, so this is something that is relevant for me. So how do I open this judgment? Now, this is the button. I can also see from here that this has been cited 6 times in other judgments. I would also like to see which are these 6 judgments this has been cited. So now I've opened this. This is how the judgment looks on Manipatra. Compassionate appointment, citing references there. Let me show you just one from here. This is cited in para. So what cited in para does for you is it gives you the list of all the 6 judgments which it has been cited in. Now recently, a judgment from Allahabad High Court 21, this is there. Now it goes a step further. It also gives me the paragraph where this judgment was cited. Okay. Another judgment is from here. This is a 2018 judgment. So all these judgments are also helpful to my research. Now I have started with one judgment, and from here I'm able to see at least six more judgments that might be helpful for me. And these are the more recent judgments. So if you want to quote these, you can always quote them also. So this is what I've shown you here is how to find where a particular judgment is cited from here. And it also reduces your work because you don't have to go to the judgment, find the paragraph. Everything is available. If you find this portion, this particular portion relevant for you, you can always click onto this button and you will be able to see. Okay, this is one. Let's go back to Manu search and make other searches. Say order 7, rule 11. So very common search, but a little specific. Order 7, Rule 11, so it has brought me 41,000 on judgment for Order 7, Rule 11A. So no need to put any inverted commas, no need, nothing like that. So this is only possible in Manu search. And because there are many search engines that might not be able to do this, and if they are able to do this, there is a very complicated way to do this. So this is, everything is available. It also picks up the Roman 7 also. That is also available from here. Let me show you on basis of topics. Say I want to say look for gender justice. Okay, so gender justice has given me 6,000 some 780 results. Now sometimes clients ask us, I don't want to read 6,780 judgments on gender justice. So to that we reply that you don't have to, because an algorithm is such that it gives you the best 10 results in the first page. Nobody likes to go on the second page. So everything available, your right keywords that are being cited more. So everything is taken into consideration here and the best results are provided in front of you. Now sorting is also there by relevance. If you want to see the newest one first, out of these 6,000 some judgments, I want to see the newest one that I can do. I want to see which is the most cited. So this Vishakha judgment has been cited 464 times. Similarly, this another judgment has been cited just 4 times. So I wanted to read judgments which are more cited. So that I can do. Okay. So this was for Manu search. There are a lot of things here. There's nesting. There's some, you can also use Boolean search in this one. We'll be discussing that tomorrow. This is just an introduction to different searches. So let's go to the next one. This is legal search. Okay. So now legal search, what is the difference between Manu search and legal search? So legal search you go to when you have a specific section in your mind, when you have a particular appellant respondent in your mind, say, or you have a date of a decision. So sometimes what happens is, that you read a news article, okay, so it has appeared in say Times of India of September 2019 and now it's a Delhi High Court judgment and that is relevant to what you have been researching. So you just select one date, fourth, select Delhi and make a search. Now, from here, you will be able to see 17 results delivered on that date. From here, you can always search in result to get to the specific thing you are looking for. Okay. Let's start with legal search again. So this is just based on a particular date you can make your search. Now based on the subject also, we have different subject categories. So 50 subjects are there. Based on those subject categories also, you can make the search. So you have a particular respondent name, say you have a party in your mind, so you can just search on party name. Now what happens here is I have written Konkan Railway there, so it will only search in the title of the judgments. So when you search in Manu search, it searches the entire body. When you make the same search through the appellant respondent table, it will only search where the title is there. Okay. You can also make a search by the act. So one way to make your act search is from the bare act folder. The other one is if you don't want to go there, you can select this negotiable instruments act and say 138. Make a search. Okay. So this is all the judgments on NI 1338. It's sorting them in relevance, newest date. If you want to see the cited most. The most cited decision on NI Act 138 is available here. Say we were doing for NI Act Section 138, making my search, selected cited most. So these are the most cited most cases on Negotiable Instruments Act 138. Section wise search is also present. So if I want to see a particular judgment, say this is 2006 judgment, to see, so this is how a judgment looks on Manupatra. So this is citing references there, body is there, acts, rules. Now, again, I'd like to bring your attention to the hyperlinking. So section 138 has been hyperlinked to the act, to the commentary, to the digest. So if I just want to read the act, that I can do. Negotiable Act 118 is available. If you want to read more judgments on this, that also you can do if you want to see the digest. Similarly, any case also, if it's there, it's also mentioned to the link to the case. So now this is one such judgment. Click on to this one and it will show me where it is hyperlinked. So this is a very common small basic feature, but it's not very common. Most of the software don't have this. Let's go to any word. So there's this option available which you might like. So this is a dictionary option. So what I've done here is I've just selected one word and there's a no more option that appears. You can select dictionary and it gives you. Okay. Something is wrong with the net. Collaborated. So it basically gives you the dictionary meaning of that particular word from here. Now let's come to the case note. This is the case note for that judgment. Citing reference. So citing reference is they have referred these many cases in this particular judgment. Now I want to see which of these cases, how have they treated them in this particular case? What they just discussed. So these are the five cases which were discussed in this judgment. Were they relied on? So these were the judgments which were relied on. This is one judgment which was distinguished. So if you are reading, if you are finding this judgment helpful, you can always go to this judgment and see why have they distinguished this. So similarly mentioned is also available. Prior history of the judgment is there. Cases referred. So these are the cases that were referred in this particular judgment. These are the acts. All the acts that were mentioned in this one are also there. Subject wise is also there. So these are again our editorial inputs. So we have provided that this is related to criminal and banking. Now this is the Manu citation. So Manu citation, once you click onto this one, this will give you the equivalent citation. So we have equivalent citations from 320 plus journals. You can just, all the volumes are available from these journals. Other thing that you can do is if you want to click into this wheel, you'll be able to see the treatment in other cases. So this case, which is Narayanan Menon versus State of Kerala. So this was discussed 69% times in other cases. This was relied on 17% times in other cases. This was mentioned 12% times in other cases. So all this is also available. So you can find that information. Now coming to some of our loved features, which is, this is view commentary. So any commentary, if it's available, that is also available here. If you want to, this is important para. So important para gives you the key paragraph of any judgment. So this is Narayanan Menon. So it gives me the paragraph, which is a key paragraph. Now, how do we decide which is the key paragraph? It is based on the times it has been cited in different cases. Okay. So this paragraph, people have verbatim taken 17th and they have quoted in future judgments. Okay. So this judgment came out in 2019. They have quoted it. Another this judgment, they've again quoted. So it gives you a list of all the paragraphs. Now this has been quoted 3 times. Okay, so you get a list of all the paragraphs in this judgment which have been quoted in future judgments. So basically these are the law points of the judgment, because therefore they are being quoted in other judgment. So now I find that this particular judgment is what I was searching for. This is the exact paragraph. This is the thing. Now I can always read this judgment from here. So it's saving me time. It's giving me more options to read whichever relevant judgments, other relevant judgments are there. And it's also giving me a direct link to open that judgment. Now coming, this was the first one. This was important para. This we have discussed earlier. This is cited in para. So cited in para again shows me where this judgment has been cited in other judgments. Now, what is the difference between important para? Important para was giving me the paragraph of this judgment. Okay. Cited in para gives me the paragraph from the other judgments where this judgment has been cited. So there's a Gujarat High Court judgment that came out in 2020. And it has quoted the judgment in 6-1. And there's another Karnataka High Court judgment which has quoted it here. So all the list of 841 cases where this judgment has been cited is available here. If you want to use it in your drafting, just one paragraph if you want to use. So that also you can do. Control C, press Control V, it's no problem. Normally also from part of the judgment, there are softwares which have problems with copy pasting. From here, you can just Control C, Control V to any software. So there's no problem in copy pasting. The next one is authority timeline. So authority check, what it gives me is where this judgment was cited. Number one, these are the 841 cases over the years where it is being cited, this particular judgment. Narayanan Menon. Now it also gives me the citing reference. What was the treatment given to this case? So in how many cases this was relied on? In how many cases it was distinguished? And in how many cases it was dissented? So there are like 2 judgments, one from Karnataka High Court, another one from Supreme Court, which is dissented with this case. So many a times you have a case and you want to find a case which is more, which is affirming that case. That you can do. And if you want a case which is counter to that particular case, that also you can find dissented here. This is very useful. Again, the next one is case map. Now, what case map does for you is it gives you a visualization of 20 relevant cases to Narayanan Menon versus State of Kerala. So these are all the judgments that. On the left hand side, you can also take it as a timeline. So this is 2006. These are the cases that have come before 2006 and have been cited in MS Narayanan. Okay. So from here, you will be able to see that this particular judgment was discussed in this. Again, State Delhi Administration, this case was relied on MS Narayanan. So these are the different cases which were cited in, and some was discussed, some were distinguished. There was one case which was distinguished. This is that one. And these are the cases that were followed. So what happened to MS Narayanan after 2006? So these cases came. So it was dissented in one case. It was relied on one case. It was discussed in one case. So all these are available to you. And one thing I'd like to point out, you know, at different sizes also. So this particular case has been cited less, and this is a more, this balloon is bigger, so this particular judgment in itself has been cited more. Okay, then now there are different lines that are available. So here this judgment was mentioned in many judgments. Now that judgment was also discussed in this. All these treatments are available to you. Now if you want to click on any judgment, now this becomes the center of the solar system. Next is you can follow this case. So where this particular system was relied on, where this was discussed, where this was mentioned. So that also you can follow from here. Okay, coming to the next one, highlighted catchwords, which are the common catchwords that are, which are the common words that are occurring in this judgment. So I just want to go to appeal against acquittal, directly go from there. Okay. This is available in the PDF format also. So if you want to download the PDF format, you can do that without or with case note. Now, if you want to mail it to your friend, that also you can do. Just click onto this one. From here, you will be able to send a mail. It will go in the PDF. Word format is available. So if you are formatting and you need the Word format, that is also available. Sticky note is there. We'll be discussing this in detail tomorrow. This is upload this document. So this is, if you want to save it in cloud, that is also there. You can also save it in Manu cloud. You can create folders in Manupatra. So let's save in the arbitration folder. This will be saved. So whenever I want to access this, I can access it from here, my save docs. Now this one, the print replica is also available. So print replica is basically the judas copy. So this is as it is appearing in the Supreme Court website. Many times what happens is people change the paragraph for a particular judgment. So Manupatra don't do that. And if you want to check, is there any problem with it with other judgments or other publishers, the source copy is always available here. This was for legal search. Now I'll just show you one citation from citation search. Then we'll show you how to keep you updated through Manupatra. Rest of the things, there are many things that I need to unpack. I know I'll be doing that in tomorrow's session. Okay. So this is a citation search. So sometimes you will be just be given different citations, of one citation of the judgment. So you can easily find the judgments from there also. So this is like all the journals that we are covering. So more than 336 journals are there, very comprehensive list. So if you have a citation from any of these journals, you will be able to access that also. Say AIR Supreme Court and enter a year 1998. You can enter a page number. No need to remember any format, nothing. Just put in the volume number, put in the page number, and you will be able to get to the judgment from there. So this is, from here you will be able to get to the judgment from citation search. So this was a brief introduction to Manu search, legal search, citation search. We also looked into how to get to the various documents from this table of contents. Now let me just show you one last thing. How to keep yourself updated through Manupatra. So this is one, there are many options available. This is on desktop. So we have a desktop alert. This is a small software that comes. You can download that and you'll be able to see, this is how it looks. So when you download it, you'll be able to get these alerts. So I'm getting it for 15th April. So anytime a new alert comes, that you can access from there. Similarly, Chrome alert is there, so you can download it on your Chrome. And from here, you will be able to quickly glance through what's happening in the legal front. Similarly, we have other options like if you have a Telegram account, you can go to Play Store, download Telegram, and Manupatra Channel 7 is there. You can join it. So daily, we send you some alert, just one message of all the alerts of all the major happenings in the legal front today. That you can download from Telegram, and you will be able to keep yourself updated. These are the 2-3 things that you can do, small things daily, so that you are updated on Manipatra. So this will be for today. Tomorrow we have another session there, how to do Boolean search, how to use nesting. So these are how to use artificial in analytics in this one. So we will discuss it tomorrow. Okay. So if you have any questions, we can take them. Yes, sir, please tell us. Hello. Hello, Mr. Lakshmikant.
First of all, thank you for the short webinar. Okay. I had a question. Once we open the judgment, we have cited in para, there is an option, right? So yes. There is one more icon which is which says as cited in manu, right? M.
Yes. So that is.
Yeah.
So that is, tell me, sir, about that.
Sorry?
So that is not cited in manu, that is, it gives you the important paragraph.
Okay, important paragraph of the judgment, right?
That was supposed to give you the important paragraph, yes.
Okay, so that option is available everywhere, because I have not seen in mine this thing. So that's the thing. That is an additional value added, this thing we have to go to settings and add that, or is it by default it will be there?
Okay, so this will be there for the Supreme Court judgments only, and it will only be in those Supreme Court judgments which have a paragraph which was quoted in other judgments. So all the Supreme Court judgments won't have this. So you might have to check which judgment is there which is having a paragraph which was quoted in future judgment.
Okay, fine. Okay. Got your point. Yeah. Thank you. Thanks. Yeah.
Thank you. Thank you, Lakshmi. So that is all from us. If you have any queries, any suggestions regarding Manupatra, if you want to have a similar sessions before pre-COVID days, we were doing these sessions for offline also in your colleges. So we can arrange that. If you want to have an online session with us these days, we can arrange for that. If you have any other suggestion, feedback regarding Manupatra, you can always contact us at contact@manupatra.com. Thank you for joining me for this session.